All right. We are official.
Okay, so why don't you just for text tell me your name and your title again?
My name is Dwayne Newsom.
Jolie Vitale.
Joe Haggerty. I am a data scientist.
Manager of data engineering.
Director of BI and analytics at Carhartt. Carhartt was born out of serving and protecting railroad workers.
131-year-old company.
Since 1889.
Carhartt's customers are hardworking tradespeople, outdoor enthusiasts, all kinds of people.
Over the past 10 years, our U.S. facilities have manufactured 31 million garments, which is an average of more than 3.1 million pieces of product per year.
The initial problem was we wanted to expand our brick and mortar.
As a merchandiser, it's really important that we have the right product when our consumers want it and where they want it.
There was one kind of key moment where we thought it would be really good to open a store. You kind of look at the economic data and say, yeah, that's a growing area, the population's growing, and it looked like an ideal place to open a store.
We got very far down the line of planning and started to realize that for our wholesale partners in that market, that may not have been the best decision.
If we did open a store there, we could cause some problems for retailers X, Y, and Z. Well, that was kind of a big turning point. And then we thought, well, hey, you know, we have all this data.
What?
We have this data.
The Carhartt demand system was created to project demand at the postal code level by month for all 10 of our distribution channels in order to make more strategic market selection decisions. So the data set our data engineers developed is roughly 1.75 billion records with a parameter space of 83 million parameters.
Wow, this model is huge.
The thing overwhelmed any server that we could throw at it, and basically we gave up.
This thing needed high performance computing.
We really had to scale.
And that's when we decided to reach out.
We have a very small and scrappy team. Microsoft definitely stood out as a partner.
We really needed people that could offer the big computing capability.
Data is allowing us to automate decisions to start to work smarter.
Automation is absolutely integral. We have the Azure Machine Learning pipelines, training, evaluating, and deploying the model. And then we have the Azure DevOps pipelines, or MLOps pipeline, that is actually doing all the rest of the orchestration with infrastructure. The reason we used Azure Machine Learning was not just because of the MLOps capability that it was bringing, but also because of our ability to use HPC compute clusters.
It actually lets us crunch through all of this data and go from days of compute time to hours.
What were some of the tools that were utilized to build this solution?
Microsoft SQL Server,
Azure Blob Storage,
Kubernetes,
Azure Data Lake,
GitHub.
Obviously, our Azure Machine Learning platform, just the heart and soul of this whole thing.
Working with Microsoft Azure Machine Learning is allowing us to continue to add and enhance this model. We now are using data to project out so that we can get the right product where we need it, when we need it.
We're actually optimizing work at our warehouses.
We opened 3 of our retail store locations in 2019 based on this new way of looking at the market. Those 3 stores were already amongst our highest performing stores and exceeded their revenue goals by 285%. We're going to be able to deliver more value, but we'll only be able to do that with the power of Azure Machine Learning behind us.